Ladies and gentlemen, may I present for your intellectual and philosophical pleasure...
Run Fez on Raw Dog.
Raw Dog.
Sirius XM Comedy Hits. Channel 99.
It's the Brian and Fez show with an odd theme song today. Chris Stanley, explain to me why we start the show off with the Bangles.
Well, what day is it today?
It's Monday.
What's the name of this song?
It's Manic Monday by the Bangles.
I think it all lines up pretty well. I want to try something new this week.
Well, it can't be new because every top 40 station... in the mid-80s, tried it. So it's the exact opposite of new.
See,
it's antique. It's classic. Yeah.
They tried it. We're doing it. And we're doing it successfully right now on Monday. Because so, this is a madness. Feels like a...
Are we going to do this on Mondays or...
See, I want to do a different day name for every day of the week. So Tuesday, there'll be a Tuesday song. Wednesday, a Wednesday song. So on and so forth.
Then what's the Tuesday song?
No,
what happens
Thursday
on Thursday?
We'll be fired. And then we can go back to having an opening. That makes sense. Well, you don't want to give away the Tuesday song now, do you?
No. It's going to be a surprise to everyone on Tuesday.
I'm going to get to the button. See, this is what happens with my life. Friday, after the show, I got the guys together and I go, you're not being creative enough. So... as a way to punish me by saying that, Chris tries to start the show with Manic Monday by the Bangles.
It's a great song. I mean, do you not like it?
You know who wrote this song?
No, I don't. Bangles?
Prince.
That's why must be why I like it so much.
You just said, no, I don't, and then said Bangles in a half-assed way.
It's when he was working at his office job, and it just really spoke to him.
Is there a song called Hicks is Fired? Will Chris Stanley pick up your last check?
Oh, Jesus.
Look around in your dilette for that.
I think
because this is a fireable offense.
Is there a theme song, The Tuesdays with Maury? Like when you open up the book, like when it's one of those cards?
That fucking guy. You know that it wasn't like he was with him when he was sick. He just went there for a couple of Tuesdays when he found out that he was going to die. It wasn't like it was Tuesdays for 5 years. You know what I mean? Like you do with a friend. It was like, oh, you're dying? I'll be there for the last 5, 6 Tuesdays of your life.
You should have called it Terminal Tuesdays. Because, I mean, geez, before that, who cares, right? Who cares about Maury?
The amount of time.
It's exactly right. He didn't care until he read a thing in the paper that said that this guy is dying. And he's like, I'm going to call him up and see if he remembers me. And I'm going to come in and see him every Tuesday. And I know this because he was on CBS Sunday morning a few weeks ago.
So he's just like, I'm going to use this old dying man. And I don't care.
I'm not going to be as cynical as you, man, right. Monday.
It's my fun day.
You don't have the run day? Or you do have the runs day?
That's most days.
Could you know where how to find Babel Fish? Find out how to say... in Polish, I hate you, Chris, or I hate you, Chris Stanley. See if you can figure that out. Going to Babelfish, figuring out the translation. You want to go from English to Polish.
He is slow as molasses.
It's Babelfish is all you have to write.
I thought that was an actual fish.
Oh, my God.
The fish will tell you.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear that, Fez.
I said the fish will tell you.
That's a quick one-liner. Our own Fez Watley is here this week. he is wearing a
So what was it? What about Chris Stanley? It
Can
was,
you go from English to Polish?
Yes.
It's I hate you, Chris Stanley. Okay. In Polish, please.
If that doesn't work, you can ask any Polish person.
Nien wodzi si Chris Stanley.
Let's see if I can say it properly. Nien wodzi si Chris Stanley.
What was that?
Nien wodzi si Chris Stanley.
I recognize the last part.
All right, so that's what fucking Chris brought is his creativity. By the way, I said that this was going to be the summer of Tito's.
Yeah.
Talked with our friends at Tito's. Just telling them, hey, I'm going to make the guys do exciting stuff so they can be more like Tito. Oddly enough, and I know this sounds nuts, Tito's may want to get involved in this. They may want to sponsor the summer of Tito's. Makes me feel like I wish I would have said the summer of goddamn Zale Diamonds. But yeah, it looks like Tito's wants to get involved in that. So, your thing, I told you, be more creative. You came up Manic Monday, and then Tuesday song, you only have a couple of things, I guess. Goodbye Ruby, Tuesday, Tuesday's gone.
There's plenty out there.
That's your creativity.
Day songs.
You know how I always say, you're better off making a mistake than not doing anything?
Yeah.
I was wrong. What you did...
Yeah.
Is worse.
Don't
than not
work.
Doing anything.
Stop working.
It's actually worse than dead air. What you just did.
I thought that was going to be a home run for the show and for me.
Fez, what's your big creativity you bring into the show? Oh, before you say that, Fez, I want to bring this up because I don't know exactly when it's happening. We're going to be talking to one of the greatest record producers of all time, and it kind of ties in for me with the Tito's summer. Because this gentleman has produced the Rolling Stones, John Mayer. As a matter of fact, he produced that big Beatles thing that was done.
The 50 year?
Yeah, the 50 years. He's seriously one of the greatest producers of all time. Won a Grammy with Bonnie Raitt. And now he is the CEO is the name of it, of Blue Note, the great jazz label. Don Was from Was. Is it Was Not Was or Was Not?
Was Not Was.
Was Not Was. A great funky band from the 80s. But Don Was is going to be in here. Willie Nelson, Kris Kristofferson. I mean, the list goes on forever. He's going to come in here, and I want you guys, seriously, I'm not even making this up, to really pay attention, because this is a fantasy life he's lived. Now, if I said to Don Was, I need a big idea to start off my Monday show, he's not going to play a 28-year-old Bengals song. I would have rather you played the Bengals fucking song. So, Fez, what is your big idea? Creative idea.
A little bit later in the show, I'll have a brand new character I'm debuting.
What is it?
Well, I want to keep that a secret for now.
Come on, you got to give it to us right now. It's the Monday start off.
Is it Jersey Joe?
No, it's not Jersey Joe.
What is it?
It's a wrestling character.
What is it?
It's the new world champion.
Let's have a little bit of the character, please.
It's me, the new world champion.
Right, Fez, stop.
Sounds like Jersey Joe.
Chris?
Yeah.
Congratulations, you've moved into next to last place.
All right.
That was embarrassingly bad. I'm the new world champion, and I'm champion of the wrestling. You know what you want to do?
What?
Just write a fucking letter right now to Dan Soder saying I quit. I tried to do your gimmick, and I failed miserably. And by the way, you know what Fez's thing when he does characters is that he'll say the name of the character within the first line of meeting them.
So it's so introduced
someone's
to
name
the...
would be New World Champion. That's like, come up with a Western guy. Cowboy guy. My name is Cowboy Horse Riding Guy.
Wow.
With six guns.
Welcome to town.
How could you sit there, play the Bengals Manic Monday, yeah, and not be the worst person on the show? All right, Shelby, it's your turn now. And by the way, the summer of fucking Tito's, I saw by Fez, he attempted to make it the summer of Cheetos. Like, I haven't fucking worked out anything. I'm going to say it's coming later, you know, after this bit is done, so that I can keep working on it.
You're going to have Cheeto dust all over your fingers. It's going to get over the board. It's not going to work out.
Well, that's why I made fun of it instead of saying it was a good thing. Shelby, your opportunity now.
I thought of a game show, mm-hmm, instead of like a same name game show.
Mm-hmm.
Same name game. Go with like Ice T, Ice Cube, Mr. T, or then like a glass of iced tea. Like, who said it? We can do like a quote type game with that. Or maybe like a lyric. Something like that.
You guys gotta understand
sound effect.
Something. I'm now making this the new thing, the Monday morning pitch meeting. I want to force people to pitch on Monday morning so that I know they come in fresh. So, you're saying it's iced tea.
Or Mr. T.
What, like, could it be like a Long Island iced tea? Or even a Shelley Long Island iced tea? You know? Or a Yates and Shelley Long Island iced tea.
Just so you can keep that going the longest, or?
Yeah, just keep on going with it. Is that your game?
I think of, that could work. I was thinking of, or, like, we could go with, like, John Witherspoon and Reese Witherspoon. Do, like, a quote from them. Like, see, like, a caller could call in.
As long as they had the last name together, then we'd have to say who said something, John Witherspoon or Reese Witherspoon.
Yeah, or you also have Kate Hudson or Kate Hudson, also known as Katy Perry. It's a real name.
It's weird. Why'd she change her name from Kate Hudson?
So you're interested in this non-existent, ridiculous game.
It's got my interest.
Okay, that moves him in the first, and you in the second. Then I got fucking 40 yards of duck shit, and then the new world champion. Listen how I... Dan Soder was in here the other day doing a perfect impression. So Fez hears it and goes, I'm going to come back with a wrestling guy, only he's going to be imaginary and not thought out. So you're Pinterested in what he's doing right now.
I want to pin that. I want to pin his...
Is that what they say?
Yeah, pin it. You pin things on Pinterest.
Which, you Pinterest them.
Yeah, you Pinterest them. You pin
them. I'm not Pinterested in your pictures.
Exactly.
I'm going to take my pin out.
So this game, we could call it...
Your game that you put together, you tried to sneak in racial things in the middle of conversations.
I'm definitely interested in that.
Yeah.
I was normally going on like the similar sounding names. You know, you got I was watching Law and Order SVU starring Ice-T, and I heard some Ice Cube playing in the background, and it was really hot, and I didn't have any AC where I live, so I was drinking an iced tea, and it all just kind of came to me at the same time. Like, they're kind of like similar names.
All right, I'm going to say this right now.
Yes.
I've got to do Don Was in just a little bit.
Right.
When I'm done that, when we get back, will that give you enough time to put this game together? See, here's what I worry about. There's two things I worry about right now. Number one, no one needs to hear Don Was more than you do.
Yes.
You know, you need to focus, and you need to fucking Ford focus, okay? You need the Henry Ford focus on what the fuck is going down, you know? But before you John Henry Ford focus, or even a big John Henry Ford focus, or a Mr. Big John Henry Ford focus. See, I can't get anybody into that game. I'm just building. You know, if I did a Mr. Big John Henry Ford Focus.
About Long John Henry Ford.
Yeah, you got Mr.
Yes, that's a fucking band. He didn't get it, Fez.
No, he's back at the bottom.
No, I've had to be above world champion.
I'm the new world champion.
Seriously. That's the worst thing ever. There's actual people that you can do. Oh, I got a new character for you guys. I'm a football player. Hey, everybody. Want to play football with me? I'm a football player.
What position do you play, football player?
God, Fez. You've been in the business 8 minutes less than me. And for that entire 8 minutes, for that entire stretch of your life, you've been in an inner tube just hoping the fucking river will take you down.
Right
now,
I'm
shit down for Chris.
Right now, I'm thinking.
How many times I got to tell you to say it?
10 minutes, Mr. Was.
Till him?
Till him.
This changes everything. So anyway, we're doing great until you didn't understand the fucking game.
The game. Rapper. Game on.
You're missing this.
Huh?
Could you put something together that quickly?
Okay, we kind of have like half a premise, and I could that you still have to like pull the sound clips, maybe get quotes, figure out more names. In the span of an interview plus breaks, I might be able to. I'll try my best if I leave now.
I honestly, there's nothing I hate more than people who say they're going to try to do something. That would be for me fireable. Like, again, let's take it back to football. You have a guy, you're like, I'm sending you the post. Can you get open for a TD? I'll try. I'm not saying I can because it's really hard because they have a defensive guy to follow me around.
Revis is out there.
I'm going to try.
Fucking guy's an island.
But I will say this. Even if I don't catch it, I bet I can probably knock it down so that they don't intercept it.
It probably won't be a pick six. I mean, could I give you that much?
You know, it might be a good idea is to throw it to a tight end because they're, you know...
Okay, I will absolutely have this game done by the time we get back.
Any confidence.
I will have this done.
Or you'll hang yourself.
Live on the air.
You're gonna clean up the shit and piss then, because that's what happens.
You don't weigh enough to hang yourself.
He went, yes, last week, Fez says that you didn't weigh enough to get in the water. And now he's saying you don't weigh enough to hang yourself. You know the body issue thing. It's as bad to tease somebody about being thin as it is to be being fat.
It's body dysmorphia.
Yeah. You would think a gay man would understand that more than anyone else. That is if that person was actually gay.
This is like the reverse of that Louis episode. Me and Fez used to just have a walk down by the water.
Worst thing about the Louis Fat Girl episode?
What?
The person that called her disgusting. Our own Jim Norton.
Yuck.
So people are like, Louis's good and Jim's bad. But Louis wrote that joke for Jim to do. And then you had to think this. He's sitting in front of his, you know, computer and like, oh, this is great. Let's see, a comedian calls her disgusting. Who could I get? Who could I get?
Ooh.
Can't wait to play this game that's absolutely going to be done.
By the way, in that Fat Girl episode, did you notice the famous movie director who was in that scene?
No.
Not one of you assholes did, huh?
I didn't catch it.
Did the... show of ours three separate times. Mr. Ed Burns.
I'm a jerk off.
Yes, you are, Chris.
I'm going to jerk myself off. This isn't,
all right.
Never mind. I didn't want to ruin anything.
I thought it was Louis. I know he directed Pootie Tang.
Pootie Tang.
Was he one of the joggers or?
No, no, he was being nice to her. He was the guy that, remember, Louis was like watching her kind of flirt around with someone. When you're kind of like, hey, she is kind of cool.
Yeah, they were in the upstairs above the Comedy Cellar in the restaurant.
Right.
And yeah. I had a nice shot of Mr. Ed Burns.
Yeah.
Looking great.
Ed Burns is a very attractive man, and straight people can say that without coming off gay.
Yeah. I mean, he's a really good-looking dude.
Mm. He is a thick-cocked fucking god.
I mean, all I could do is stare at his bulge.
I mean, I'm like, please, just in my face. You know what? This Manic Monday does have us all in a better mood. Don was coming up in just a few moments. Are you familiar with the jazz label Blue Note?
I know Blue Note, and I know I've heard the name Don was so much associated with such great fucking music.
Well, I was asking you about Blue Note.
Yes.
Why don't you try to forge focus
right.
for fucking 2 seconds?
This is your last Malcolm Jamal warning.
He fucking made you look like a dick then.
I'm not a dick.
Yeah.
Mr. Big John Ford, focus on the family.
All right. It is the Ron and Fez show. Don was coming up in just a couple moments, and you'll be doing your new game, right?
Yes, I'll have an intro.
What is it going to be about? It's like intro. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, run down to the production, get them to put together an intro. If you want to do a voice, you know, you need a voiceover for it. There's a new character called Wrestling Champion that everybody's crazy about.
And the new world champion.
Fez, seriously, that's what you came in with? Did you forget that you were supposed to have something new for Monday?
Manic Monday.
This was something that I just threw together.
And you're proud of that?
No, I had forgotten.
Jesus.
They should forget to send you a check.
Check, please.
That sounded just like that asshole. Do your character again. Yeah. Got it.
Chuck Pearl.
See, I call that the tag team fucking champion right now. What are you putting three up for me? You and who? Three buddies going to jump me?
No.
Why are we pressed into this like it's the most important? You got 3 minutes. What's that about?
I'm the world champion. Right.
What'd your mom teach you about fucking teasing special kids? You know? He's on the show with me. Later, Fez, you're going to tap dance. So it's going to go fantastic. Anything else we got going on today? I mean, Don Was is a lot.
Pretty ridiculous.
Any comedians stopping by?
Possibly. I'm waiting for some final confirmation.
Oh, Jesus.
I'll know after the interview. He'll have a game show, and well, I'll possibly have a guest for us later after this interview.
I'm annoying. I'm so annoyed with everything happening after Don Was.
But Don Was has to take precedence. This is like triage.
Mm. It looks like, by the way, I don't want to update people on Fez's health, but it looks like he's going to get Tommy John surgery.
Hey, he'll come back stronger.
Yeah. It looks like he's crushed his funny bone, if I had to guess.
Got to get that back up in the mid-90s.
You got to get that jack up in the mid-90s. By the way, how's your dick working for you, my friend? Is it working yet?
Flowing like a river. A jizz river.
That's really bad the other way.
In what way?
Well, before it was just dust. There was nothing. Now it's nonstop.
The jizz must flow.
Oh.
White water rafting.
All right. Enough. This is too gay for me.
Little congealed, though.
Ooh. That's fucking disgusting.
That is disgusting.
Better than nothing, I say.
I guess.
Oh, did you just stop taking your meds? You said fuck it.
Yep.
He fucking said let the cancer grow.
Let the cancer grow in that jizz flow.
Let it grow. Let it grow. Let Shelby's cancer grow.
In the jizz flow.
I'm gonna let it go. Let it go. I don't give a shit anymore.
it go when you call me a dumb cunt or whore. I don't care what your dumb fans say on your message board. I'm less of a bitch than Fez anyway.
I wonder if that's what we should be playing before we introduce the great Don Was.
No.
If there's anything I could be in life, right? I think I would pick great music producer, even over great film director. I think it's a cooler lifestyle.
It's fucking super cool because you're just constantly working with different people. I mean, and if you're like a great music producer, everyone wants you. Doesn't matter what the genre is, they want to go after you to get you. And then you work with them, and then you're out, and then you're on to the next thing. It's like a cool nomadic lifestyle.
What? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about being a record producer.
You could say the same thing if you're a fucking termite man. The fucking best thing about it isn't, oh, it's nomadic lifestyle.
I think I'd.
Why don't you be a nomad? That's what it seems like you'd want to be.
Any job. I'd be the security guard at the entrance tunnel at an NBA game, so I could just give them all high fives while they were going to the locker room.
Look, you understand that this is a fantasy, and if your fantasy is just the fucking give high fives to players, not even be a player.
Hey, King James, big ups!
Yeah. Why don't you go back to the other fucking be a mop boy at a fucking goddamn
Jack station.
That way you can fucking have a mop for your own fucking jizz anyway, you little loser. All right, Don Was is here. Really, really great, great, great record producer. Rolling Stones, Bonnie Raitt, Kris Kristofferson, Willie Nelson, John Mayer, he did his last two albums. Nobody has handed me like this amazing list of things, but it's all happening out there. He's here to talk about 100 years of the coolest jazz label of all time. He runs it now. It's Blue Note, and they're going to feature a vinyl reissue of 100 essential remastered jazz albums.
It's actually 75 years of Blue Note.
75 years, but I said they're going to be releasing 100 essential remaster jazz albums. So you don't have to worry about the years or the number of albums, just the years.
Yeah.
Do me a favor, Shelby. When you're fucking down and you're making your new thing, why I'm doing this with Don Was, right?
Yes.
When you come back here, make sure you bring your fucking mop and jizz bucket along with you.
All right.